Stop using Figma design for prototyping if you have a lot of forms and text input within your design. And get sure to watch this video until the end because I'm going to show you a better way. My name is Kia and here's Kimo. Welcome back to my channel. You must know that how difficult it is if we want to prototype a design which has a text input and form within it, and if we want that the user really be able to interact with these forms and text input. If you're familiar with the Figma, you must know that there are a lot of limitations and restrictions within the prototyping panel in the Figma design. Not so many different interaction types exist within that menu that we can use in order to create realistic and functional text inputs. So that was a little bit pity because whenever we had some sort of forms or text inputs with our design, then it was so difficult to recreate those interactions within the prototype. And therefore, we usually try to skip or find some sort of tricks to fake this effect. I have also made multiple videos in which I explain how we can use variables to create functional and clickable text inputs which the user really can enter and type something within those inputs. If you want to watch those videos, feel free to find the link in the description of this video, or you can click on the pop-up banner on top. But in this video, we are not going to talk about those tricks. What you're going to see in this video is that I'm going to use Figma design to design my pages with the forms and text inputs like we do always. And then I'm going to use the Figma Make to use AI and convert the design that we have to completely clickable and functional prototype. And in order to make it more practical, at the end, we're going to use the Supabase database to store the data that we gather from the user. To show you all the things, I'm going to create one registration page and login page, which users can basically easily interact with the pages, give the information they have, register, and then in the login page, we will do the authentication process. But before we go further, get sure to subscribe to my channel if you're new here, and if you haven't done it yet, like the video and share it with the other designers in your community if you believe this video is going to help them as well. Now, without further ado, let's get started. In the first step, we're gonna do the design within the Figma design. If you are creating a design system or if you have a design library, of course you can use all the components and the stylings and everything else that you have in the design library. But for now, I have nothing. I'm starting from scratch. So I will use the first draft functionality in order to design my pages. Let's design the two pages that we need in this video. The first one is gonna be the registration page with the registration form. And then we're gonna have the login page. So let's open the action menu here. We're gonna search for the first draft feature, which you can see I have it in the recent panel. But if you don't have it, you can search here, first draft. And then we're gonna click on it and open this window, which is basically the place that we need to write down our prompt and ask the Figma AI to generate what we need. I need a registration form. When we write down our prompt, we can click on the make it. And then we're gonna wait for a couple of seconds to get the result. Here we are. This is the design that I'm going to work with. In a starting point, you can also change the styling of generated design by selecting or switching between this color theme and color palette that exists here. Or you can even click on, for example, make a change and yourself manually change some properties such as the theme. You can change from dark to light mode, or you can change the corner radius that has been used in the design, or the spacing even. We have the possibility to change the spacing system. So when I'm done with the design, I need another page, which is going to be the user dashboard. The user is going to log in the platform, and the user dashboard is going to be the next page that the user is going to see. I'm going to use the first draft again, and my prompt is going to be user dashboard page. Now we have these two pages that I'm going to use as a reference later on when I'm using Make to create my prototype. Let's open up one Figma Make file and then continue working on it. When you make a new Figma Make file, you're going to see this chat input, which you can start with it to build your prototype. In our case, first of all, I'm going to copy paste the design that we had. I'm going to select the frame in the design file and then copy the frame using the Commission Key Command C or Control C, and then paste it in my chat using Command V or Control V combination keys. The prompt is very easy. I just explain what exactly I want to have. I would like to have a functional registration form. I also refer to the design that I paste here. Plus, I explain that I want to have the registration and then login process as well. So we would like to have also login page. And at the end, we would like to see the dashboard if the user log in. I also mentioned that I would like to use the Supabase service in order to create a database and store all the user information. Let me just paste the second design that we had for the dashboard. And let's click on go and see what is going to happen. In this step, we just wait and see the process. And if there was any question or anything that we need to decide, the Figma Make is going to ask us in the chat. For example, like this one. In the first step, we're gonna see this message, which is asking us to connect our Figma Make to Supabase, meaning that we need to have an account there in that platform to be able to use their services. It's very easy to make an account there and it's free, so I'm gonna skip that part. And actually, if you go to the pricing tab here, you can see in the free version, actually, we already have a lot of stuff that we can use for the projects and prototypes that we are making. If we want to use this service for more complex projects, then of course you can choose among the other licenses that exist. Now that we have the account, we can get back to our Figma Make chat and click on connect. And in this step, we need to authorize this connection. But first we need to make one organization. So create your organization. And after authorizing this connection, get back to the Figma Make. But now we need a project within the Supa app that we can connect it to this one that we're making in the Figma Make. And this is what Figma Make is asking us to do. So we're gonna create a project by clicking on this button. And in the next window, we're gonna set up the basic setting of our project, such as the name, the region, and database password. I've finished the setup, so I click on create the project. This is gonna take a couple of seconds. And when it's ready, we're gonna go to the next step. Now we are connected to Supabase and our project is ready and connected to the Figma Make. Figma Make is going to work on the user interface and the logic of our platform. Figma Make is working in the background. It's actually taking not that long, but of course, don't expect that everything gets ready in a few seconds. What is happening is that the Figma Make is setting up our project, all the requirements that we need, and building the logic also, this registration and login logic. So it's going to take some time. I'm going to wait and then I'm going to show you the result. Okay, we are done and the preview is ready. Before I deep dive into the preview, really quickly, I want to show you the latest message that we got from Figma Make, which is explaining what exactly has been done so far. Registration form is ready. The login form is ready. User dashboard is ready. And the backend is also working. The next thing that I immediately notice is that we have a bunch of warning for this application. Yeah, okay, let's ask the Figma Make to fix it for me. Okay, now we have no warning or error or anything like that. Everything is ready. In order to be able to see this stuff a little bit better, I'm going to click on preview in a full screen. So I'm going to give my name here, Kia. I'm going to give my Gmail address and I'm going to also set some password. And let's click on sign up. Okay, that's great. First thing that I notice is that in our form, if we do not agree the terms or accept the term and condition, we cannot go further. So let's click on this and then sign up. Here we get the next error, which says fail to fetch. So when we get back to Figma Make, immediately we see that it's detected the error that we faced. So we can now click on fix for me. And then we need to wait again. You can see how easily we can debug the problems without even really deep diving into the code or whatsoever. Now let's try again. I'm going to give my name, Gmail, and password and sign up. I get this message that the account has been successfully created. Now I'm going to open the sign-in form and then give my email and my password and click on sign-in button. The page is going to get loaded and we see the dashboard, and also we get this message that we got logged in. So the logic is working under the hood. Let me try another time. So again, I go to login form, I give my email and password, and I click on the sign-in button and I logged in my dashboard. So that was it. You see that how easily we can create the complex prototypes that we wouldn't be able to do it before if there was no AI to help us. In less than half an hour, I designed my pages and then convert those pages into real and functional registration and login process and journey. Everything is working. The authentication process is working very well. You can register, you can log in your dashboard, and we can work further on this process. The good thing is that we can use the API from the other platform directly in the Figma Make as well. For example, if you want to create an application or one Figma Make project that is using OpenAI model or any other AI model within it, you can use their API within the Figma Make directly. Which brings me to the next topic. What would you like to see in the next video? What would you like me to make using Figma Make or in general AI for the next video? You can share your opinion and thoughts in the comment section of this video. That was it. Let's learn together and see you in the next video. Great day, cool, just show me the why.